Hello.
Hello, Adam.
Adding it to the, make sure you watch us on Twitch, twitch.tv/ESPN Chicago and on YouTube.
Before we get to the lunch rush, I do want to say from the social media response of our last segment, the list of cereals, people are outraged that none of us had Cinnamon Toast Crunch on our list.
Well, it's a good one.
Yeah. There's a lot of social outrage over all four of us leaving that off the list.
We're doing this on the fly, you guys. Off the top of our head. Cinnamon Toast Crunch is a strong recommendation. Yeah. I'm not going to lie.
Never had it. Never had it.
No, I've never had it.
All right. I'm taking out Rice Krispie Treats. Pass. That's out.
Cinnamon Remember the milk afterwards? Yeah. Yeah. There's all that sugar and cinnamon.
It's one of the few cereals you have to drink the milk afterwards.
Totally.
Yeah.
Oh, man. It's a good one. All right. The listeners got it. That's a good one. I'm not going to lie. Excellent call. Excellent.
That's fair. That's a good one. Okay. All of the charges and whatever against Scottie Scheffler have been dropped.
Yeah, I would think.
Officially dropped today. Part of the agreement is that there will be no countersuit or anything like that from Scheffler and his people. So
that's the usual. We admit no guilt.
Washing of the hands.
Yeah, interesting.
All right, but at least he can be done with it and move on. The whole thing was crazy.
I think that police officer did get was relieved of his duties, though.
Well, I think he was reprimanded. I don't know if he was relieved of his duty.
We're going to have to find that out.
I thought there was some sort of...
What about his new slacks? Did he get...
New pants?
New pants.
I don't know. The $80 khakis that he was upset were ruined?
God forbid, $80 khakis. You know, he's going to make $10 million this year.
Why wouldn't they get ruined? Did he crap settle his pants? Is that what happened?
I might have. They settle up with...
No. It's the cop's pants.
Oh, the cop's pants?
Yeah, the cop's pants.
Oh, he said that when he was dragged, they got ripped.
The video, so he never got dragged.
Part of the settlement is that they had to give him some Kohl's cash.
All right, so Scottie can take some of his $15-20 million he'll make this year. But here, go buy new pants.
But it wasn't because they got scuffed up or anything. It's because the cop crapped his pants.
That's just awful. It was a whole ridiculous incident from the get-go. I'm glad it's
from the jump, Carmen. Yeah. We were there.
Well, not really.
Well, we were in Louisville when the thing was going on, so don't tell me we weren't there.
Well, we were back in Illinois when it actually happened. We were in Louisville a couple of days before.
But we felt the aura of what was happening down there.
Got it.
Thank you.
When I first saw it that morning, I woke up. I'm like, oh, my God, what did Scottie Scheffler do? And I'm like, that's it?
Yeah.
I was like, Scottie Scheffler? He's the nicest guy ever. What did he do? So silly. All right, go ahead, Adam. What else?
Yesterday, Drake May signed his contract, a fully guaranteed four-year $36.63 million deal that comes with a $23.46 million signing bonus. I'm just mentioning this news to ask the general question, when's Caleb going to sign, and should we start to worry about when he's going to sign?
I don't think we have to start worrying about it yet. At some point, it's going to be a story whether we like it or not. I'd say let's wait until August 1st. If by August 1st, there's no contract.
That's through training camp.
Well, no. August, the training camp starts like the 23rd,
July,
right?
Isn't it in July?
23rd. Well, yeah, but it's not
July.
Through.
Okay.
Yeah,
all right. August 1st. Okay.
If by August 1st, I think we're going to start talking about it more. And it still might not be a big deal. It's not really a big deal until September 5th, I guess.
Yeah. Whose contract?
Caleb Williams.
He'll be signed before they go to training camp. It's not even going to be a problem.
Okay. I hope.
I mean, it's slotted. It's no issue. You know, you got the fifth year. There's not going to be any, what is that, set? What kind of set like stuff he, language
well,
is
like
that?
Well, like offset language.
Offset. There won't be no offset language in there.
Listen, if he's determined to get some sort of guarantee that he won't be franchised, that ain't happening.
That's never going to happen.
And that could get ugly then.
That would be his issue, and he doesn't want to play football then. That's it.
That ain't happening.
He's going to get franchised, period.
Yeah, exactly.
You're not going to take that tool away from the football team.
There's no way.
It shouldn't even be allowed according to CBA or whatever agreement that the NFL should mandate. That's not even a possibility.
Yeah. There's no way that's
not going to happen.
If that's a real thing, then that could get ugly.
It's not going
to
happen.
I don't expect it to be.
Zero. Ever.
August 1. Remind me on August 1st and be like, hey, you said August 1st. It's done. Then we'll be like, I guess we got to talk about it.
I think Jurko's right. If it's not done by training camp, we'll talk about it before August 1st.
You might be right. Like if they go to camp and it's not done, you're probably right. But I'm just saying it maybe isn't really like, okay, we need to focus on this now until August 1. I guess we'll see.
All right, speaking of quarterbacks, Chris Sims, everybody's favorite quarterback ranker, has started to release his top 40 QB countdown. Notables in the 30s, Anthony Richardson at 32, Bryce Young at 34, Tannehill comes in at 31. He does not have a job right now.
Not right now.
J.J. McCarthy at 30. And then we get into Bo Nix at 29. Jaden Daniels at 28. Penix at 27. Will Levis at 26.
Jeez.
Justin Fields comes in at 25. Deshaun Watson at 24. Daniel Jones at 23. Derek Carr at 22. Russell Wilson at 21. And coming in at number 20, Caleb Williams.
It's hard to do these lists when the rookies haven't played. I mean, how is Michael Penix the 27th best quarterback in the league right now?
What's the difference? 19th and 20th in the two that we've heard? It's the same thing, basically.
Basically, it's the same thing.
We'll see where they end up measuring out.
I think it'll be...
Deshaun Watson, 24th, is a little bit of a... that's a head-scratcher.
You talk about hard lists to compile. A list like this, when a bunch of the rookies haven't even played yet, I mean, it's... Okay.
And you got a quarterback that hasn't even...
Here's what matters.
He has a team.
Here's what matters. Here's what we know. Patrick Mahomes is awesome. Joe Burrow's awesome. Lamar's awesome. Josh Allen's pretty awesome. I think Justin Herbert, I maybe overvalue him more than some, but I think Justin Herbert's pretty awesome. Those teams have quarterbacks that they can win with. That we know. That's where we hope Justin gets, right? That's it.
Justin.
Not Justin. Caleb. Excuse me. That's what matters, Jurk. Like, that's the list that matters. Where Michael Penix ranks and where Caleb Williams ranks, they haven't taken a snap in the NFL. That's a tough exercise.
Yeah, Dak Prescott could win, just not in the playoffs.
Poor Dak. I love Dak. I'm a bigger Dak fan than most as well, but yeah, poor Dak. Not poor Dak. I don't really mean that, but what else, Adam?
Speaking of Justin Fields, he laughed off being used as a kick returner.
He was
talking to the Pittsburgh Post-Gazette, and he goes, I think everybody kind of interpreted it wrong. Coach Danny was basically just trying to send a message that no matter who you are, you could be on special teams. He just used me as an example.
Yeah, I'm buying what Justin's selling there. It's a ridiculous notion to think they'd try him as a kickoff man, as a return specialist. So I'm with Justin on that one.
He basically dismissed it.
Yes, kind of silly. He's not there to be a kick returner. Yes. Anything else?
There's another big NFL list that I know you want to get to.
We'll do that coming up next. Yeah. Want to do that next?
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll do that next. There's the lunch rush. I got a few PFF things I want to throw at Jurko, Bears specific. And I want to see if we should be happy about one of their lists and where two Bears are slotted. 312-332-3776. It's Carmen and Jurko.